In this video, I'm going to show you how to make these cool health bars with Unity. Hey everyone. So first thing we have to do is to make a world space canvas. To make the world space canvas, go to game object, UI, and then go to canvas. I'm going to rename this to world space canvas. Once you have your world space canvas object, change the render mode to world space. Assign the camera to the event camera variable. And then go ahead and make the scale 0.1 on all of the variables here. Now let's make our health bar. Again, go to UI, and then we're gonna look for slider. And it's automatically gonna assign itself to the canvas. So go ahead and change its position, the X and Y to 0. So notice it has its little knob. Go ahead and open up the slider and remove the handle slide area. We're gonna change this background, make it everything 0, 0. And the fill area, because right now if you slide the value, it doesn't go all the way to the end. So change the fill area right here to 0 and 0. And now, and also change the fill to 0 on both. Go ahead and use the value, slide it all the way to 1, and notice it goes all the way to the end. And that's exactly what we want our health bar to do. So what we want also is this fill area to change color based on where it is on the bar. So it'll be red over here, orange, and then like green. So here's our slider. And one of the things is I changed the background. You can download this in the link in the description, but I'm gonna use a gradient. You can leave it as is, or you can use this gradient image that you can download. So it'll look like this. And there you go. And so let's go ahead and also turn this transition off. So, because all we need is this. We're going to dictate and change the color. And another thing, if you want maybe text to show up on the health bar, what you could do is you can right-click on the slider, go to UI and text, and make the text the parent of that fill area. And I'm going to select best fit. I'm going to change its color to white. I'm going to make this 100, just so you can see it. Change the scale to 0.5, and then I'm going to actually make the height of the health bar to 60. So you kind of have to play around the values to get something that you want. Maybe make it a little more visible. And then I think I want to change the style to bold. So that value will change when we code it. And also don't forget to change it. You want to center it as well. So let's go ahead and start coding this health bar. So I went ahead and made a script called health bar, and we're going to make a couple of variables that we want to assign. So the first one is we want access to the slider, and you also want to be using the Unity's UI component system. So assign this for this library. Next, we want the image, the fill image of the slider, because we want to change its color. And we want surface two colors that we want to lerp between. Say this is red, and this is green. What we're going to do is when health reaches 0, it'll be closer to the min. And if it reaches 100, or like the max health, it'll be closer to the max. Then we also want current health and max health. And I'm just gonna assign this to 100 for now. And that text we have in the UI component, we want access to that as well. So we're going to call it health text. And I'm just going to have a Boolean just in case you don't want to show the health bar or the health display. So for now, we're going to leave these variables in. I want to assign them in start. So at the start of the game, the current health is just going to equal max health. So we're going to start at 100. We want the slider's min value to start at 0 and the max value to start at max health. And then the value will equal max health as well, because we're going to start at, you know, full health on the slider, or it's going to be the bar is going to be fully visible. And then also we're going to assign the text. And I'm actually going to make a function. So we're going to call this getHealthDisplay. So let's make a public string for this getHealthDisplay. That's basically going to return the current health. And then we're going to add a percentage sign to it. Okay. And just so we can see the color change at runtime, let's go ahead and update the value in update for the slider. So we're going to update the fill's color, and it's going to do a lerp. That'll do the min color, max color, by current health divided by max health. So let's assign these values, and let me go ahead and show you what this is going to do. So first, let's change the slider to something more recognizable. We'll change it to health bar. All right, so let's go ahead and assign the health bar script. We'll drag on the slider UI component, drag on this fill image to this component. Let's go ahead and change the min color to like a red. And then we'll change the max color to a green. Well, you gotta change the alpha. We're gonna leave the max health as 100 and also assign the text. And these turrets right here, you can get from the Unity Asset Store. This is basically in the description of the video. So let's look at how the script functions right now. So if I go ahead and change the current health to say 40, notice it changes color based on what it is. If I change it to 0, it'll be red. Change it to 75. It's like a light green. So it's lerping between the two values. But what I want is I want this to adjust in a function. So not only does the color change, but the slider value right here also changes. So we want all that to happen at the same time. So let's go ahead and add it as a function. So to make it a function, we're gonna call this update health. And I'm going to pass in an amount that is going to update the current health. So we'll do current health plus equals the amount. And then this is where we're going to modify the value of the slider. And then we're going to modify the text. So to test this out, I'm just going to add this in the update. So when I click the mouse button, it's going to go ahead and update the health by, let's say, negative 10, just so you can see a change at runtime. And so when I click, notice it changes. It'll keep going down every time I click, and the color is changing with it. So that's the functionality we want. So now what we want is for this health bar right here, we're gonna have this a part of each one of these units. And so when you load up the map, they'll appear above these turrets. So we're gonna want access to the camera. So we also want access to this transform. And what target is when the health bar assigns itself to the world space canvas, the target is the object where the health bar will appear above. So it'll be like one of those turrets. We also want access to the canvas. And actually, I'm going to change these to be consistent. And the offset will be how much the health bar appears above the turret. So let's go ahead and assign the values. And also, one thing I want to do is the show health display text. I want to set the enabled flag equal to that, so it'll actually update depending on what we set it to. So let's assign those variables we just made. So main camera equals the main camera. Assign the world space canvas. We're going to find it in the scene. And at the start of the level, or the game, we want the health bars to assign themselves to the world space canvas so we can see it. We're also going to make sure that the health bars are always looking at the camera. So with this quaternion, it's always going to look at the camera as you rotate. And we want the health bar always to be above the target, which in this case will be one of the turrets. Target will equal the parent. Because what you'll do is the health bar will be a child of, say, the turret, and then when the scene loads, it'll assign itself to the world space canvas so you can see it. So let's go ahead and assign these variables in the scene. So we want to assign the main camera. And we'll make this an offset of, say, like 4, so we can see it above the turret. So with those variables assigned, what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this onto one of the turrets. So when I hit play, watch it be right above. So it's right above the turret. And when I click, it's going to change. But notice how large it is. So let's go ahead and modify the health bar. So I'm going to change this to 0.01 on the scale. Okay, let's hit play again. And I mean, that's a little better. Definitely something you can, you know, mess around with. So right now, it actually isn't looking at the camera because the health bar needs to be in the update function, that look rotation function. So in the update function, we're gonna make sure that the rotation, we're actually gonna copy it up here. Both of these. So it always moves with the unit and it always looks at the camera. So let's go ahead and save it. And then you'll see the health bar rotate with the camera. And when I move the turret, notice it moves with it. And now if I click, see how it's updating? So let's see what it looks like with multiple. So I'm gonna duplicate this, assign it to this turret, duplicate it again, and assign it to this turret right here. Let's hit play again, and you'll see three health bars right above. And notice they all change at the same time. It's because of where we put the update health function, but this is what it looks like right above them. I would remove this function. And what you'll want to do is just call this when you want to, you know, change the health. And if you don't want the color to change and update at all times, you could always grab it and put it here so when you actually call the update health function, that's the time it actually changes the color. So that's it for health bars with Unity. If you have any comments or questions, please post it down below. And if you want me to dive deeper into maybe health bars, let me know as well. Thanks again for watching and have a good one.